My name is Susan Cameron. I'm a wildlife biologist with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. We are actually collecting spruce cones today as part of the Southern Appalachian Spruce Restoration Initiative, which is a group of partners that is working to restore spruce across the Southern Appalachian Mountains, where its range has been greatly reduced.
Hey, my name is Kelly Holbrooks. I'm the executive director at Southern Highlands Reserve in Lake Toxway, North Carolina. We spend the winter time taking the cones and getting the seeds out. In 2013, we had a bumper crop year. We spent 120 man hours just getting the seeds out of the cones. And to date, we have over 25,000 red spruce in propagation on our site. And hopefully one day those will be on public land.
Eventually, these are going to be planted in several of our sky islands or high elevation peaks, where historically we had spruce and now there is no spruce. Or there's very limited spruce, and so ultimately we're going to try to connect patches of good spruce in the range where spruce used to exist but no longer exists. There's multiple wildlife benefits. One of the big benefits is the federally endangered Carolina northern flying squirrel is reliant on conifer trees, and so spruce is incredibly important to the species. They actually feed on mycorrhizal fungi or truffles that grow on the root systems of spruce trees.